3 months ago, we reported from West Africa on the Great Drought, the drought which was causing a mass migration south away from the Sahara Desert toward food and water. We reported too on the millions of animals that were dying from starvation. The drought was the worst that West Africa had ever experienced. What no one knew then was that while cattle were dying in West Africa, 4,000 miles across the belly of the continent in East Africa, the same drought was claiming other victims. In Ethiopia, people were dying. This is a queue for food. These people are Ethiopian peasants. Once they had cattle, land, and houses. They sold them all to buy food. Now they have only their rags. They're destitute. There are perhaps 1,000 people in this queue. In the province of Wollo, where they live, 700,000 people are in the same state. In Ethiopia as a whole, nearly 2 million people are suffering. In Wollo, there are 23 food distribution centres like this, feeding more than 250,000 starving people. Here, they receive 2 meals a day. The food, 2 handfuls of boiled wheat in the morning, and a piece of bread in the afternoon, keeps them from death, no more. Last year, these people were strong, fit, and active. They'd known hardship, of course. They'd suffered several years of drought. But a year ago, when the rains failed utterly, their crops failed too. This spring, the rains failed again. By April this year, they were starving. They dragged themselves exhausted into the towns, many of them dying on the way. These men, women and children have been like this now, surviving, not living, for 6 months. There has not been enough food. In the last 6 months in Wollo alone, at least 50,000 and possibly more than 100,000 people have died from the famine. In this month of October, thousands are still starving. Thousands are still dying. These people are now without hope. They've seen mothers and fathers and sons and daughters weaken and die. Now, family by family, they await the same end. Ethiopia is one of the poorest countries in the world. Hunger is common, disease is prevalent. The average life expectancy is 36 years. Dessie is the capital of Wollo province. It too knows suffering, but it has never before witnessed anything like this. A relief center, one of 13 in the province. It is guarded by the army to keep order and unwanted strangers out. Bodies lie scattered through the camp. Nearly 4,000 men, women and children are encamped here. They seldom stir. Even if they had the strength, which most of them have not, there's nowhere to go. They're imprisoned here by their hunger. The meals for 3,000 people are prepared by other refugees who receive extra rations for their work. There are three feeds a day. Breakfast is a cup of tea. Lunch is a piece of wheat bread. Supper is a piece of wheat bread. It is not enough to make weak people strong. There are 500 sick children in Desi, all of them suffering in various degrees from starvation. A child's body cannot bear malnutrition. Starvation kills it. The time is 11 o'clock in the morning. Their last meal was at 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon. Their first meal today is just one cup of tea. In Wollo province, there are many thousands of children in this state. They need protein, they need milk, and stocks of both have all but run out.
What are the kind of things that you look for to see the state that the children are in?
Well, mainly they are skinny and bony, malnourished, very weak. Most of them cannot walk and have difficulty.
What is it that these children need?
What they need is a balanced diet.
Balanced diet?
Yeah. Mainly protein, calories. These are the things that they are need. Most of them, they are underweight.
How close to a balanced diet are they getting now?
Well, this is only 50%. 50%. 50%.
So what is happening to these children at the moment as we look at them? I mean, are they getting better? Are they getting staying the same or what?
Well, they are getting worse and worse.
How many of these children are likely to die if they don't get more help, more assistance, more aid?
30% will die. 30% will die.
Without doubt?
Yes.
What do you need from the outside world and how quickly do you need it if these children are not going to die?
What we need from the outside world is milk, medical supplies, and also medical manpower.
People?
Yes.
And how soon do you need those?
We need them very urgently, maybe after 10 or 15 or 1 month.
Otherwise things go on getting worse and worse, is that right?
Yes.
The camp at Desi is more fortunate than the other 12. It has a special ward for sick mothers and their children. Babies are born here, to mothers too malnourished to feed them. Without the protein which they do not get, their chance of survival is remote. These 17 children will die. Too sick to be treated here, the local hospital, already overcrowded, has refused to take them. One or two will die of pneumonia. One or two will die of typhus. One or two will die of gastroenteritis. the root cause will be starvation. There is a clinic. 500 of the strongest are here each day for drugs and medicine. About the clinic wait the tattered remnants of once healthy young people, now too weak to make their way there unaided. At Desi, as at the other 12 camps, there is not one doctor. The clinic is run by a medical team of one health officer, two nurses, and five orderlies. Eight people to care for 3,000. Their day is spent here inevitably treating the strongest. The rest never reach the counter for the drugs, of which now, in any case, there is a desperate shortage. Some, a very few, are brought to the clinic just in time to be drip-fed back to their suffering. But they are the few. This sick ward should take no more than 60 patients. Here, there are 120. Some have typhus, some have dysentery, some have cholera, some pneumonia, some fever, some malaria, some gastroenteritis, and some tuberculosis. Some, again, are just starving. There is no sanitation in Desi. Disease spreads like the plague. In this shelter, nearly everyone is dying. All who are able have left for another hut. These were too weak to move. To recover, they would need intensive care. That being impossible, they are regarded as hopeless cases.
One of the most appalling aspects of what's happening here is that it's already too late to save the lives of thousands of people. For instance, those people who are in this shed here are getting weaker every day. Many of them can no longer take food or drink. All of them are bound to die. Last night, 9 people died here. Today so far, and it's only the middle of the afternoon, another 12 have died.
A frail procession of misery makes its way from one sick bay to another. It's from people like this throughout the province that the death toll is created. In Wallo, perhaps 100,000 people have died in 6 months. And now in the camps, which shelter only 14,000 of those affected, up to 1,000 die each week.
Thank you.
One man, a Catholic monk, gives comfort to the inmates of Desi. But what can he do? Who is this girl? Where is she from? Has she a family? What is wrong with her? He is here whenever he can be, but he also runs a monastery and a school. He's now exhausted. His task here is hopeless. The parents of last night's dead wait to bury their children. Right, is that right?
Yes, last night. Yes, last night until 12 o'clock. And 6 o'clock in this morning.
Between 12 o'clock last night and 6 o'clock this morning,
yes,
he died.
Yeah.
Are they all dead from starvation? From no food?
Yes.
This year, the rains have fallen. The land which was bare last year is green today. But the farmers are now in the refugee camps. Much of the land is unsown. Wallo will need grain from outside at least until the end of next year. All along the main road north of Desi, refugees from the country are still arriving in the towns. 200 miles north of Desi, Mersa is one of these towns. Like Desi, like 12 other towns, Mersa has its relief camp too. It is no better, no worse than the rest. This is the first time that the government of Ethiopia has allowed the outside world to witness this catastrophe. For 6 months until now, it has remained a secret. The delay was fatal for thousands of people. The situation was out of control. But the government does now, desperately, seek the help of the outside world. Already, many thousands of people have died. Many more will die. Until help arrives, this tragedy will go on.